In 1860, in Pembrokeshire, Wales, someone spouted the phrase, "Eat an apple on going to bed, and you will keep the doctor from earning his bread." An apple a day keeps the doctor away, right? But will it? Really? Hey there, everyone. Thank you for watching DNews Today. I'm Trace. Apples are native to Central Eurasia, what is now Kazakhstan, and they have been spread across the world by traders and travelers over the centuries. 1,500 years ago, apples appeared in Ayurvedic medicine, an ancient holistics practice, and apples were thought of as healthful by the ancient Anglo-Saxons and Romans. An apple a day sends the doctor away was first used in 1922, and unsurprisingly, it stuck around. Also, unsurprisingly, since people say it all the time, science then studied it, and apples are healthful. Eating an apple every day could prevent 8,500 vascular-related deaths in people over 50, according to the British Medical Journal. A 2011 study from the Journal of the American Heart Association found that people who ate white fruits and vegetables, apples and pears, for example, had a 52% lower incidence of stroke and heart attack. So what is it about apples? Are they some kind of miracle fruit? I mean, you know, not like the actual miracle fruit that makes things taste funny, which is awesome, by the way, but like, you know, specifically healthful. Apples contain the following building blocks as broken down by How Stuff Works. Pectin. You may have seen this on some food processing labels. Apples contain them naturally. It's a form of fiber related to reducing blood pressure, LDL cholesterol, and glucose levels. Boron, which supports healthy bones and brains. Quercetin is a flavonoid which may reduce damage from free radicals, which are atoms in the body with unpaired electrons, which can damage cells. Free radicals can also damage DNA, so reducing them has been linked to lower risks of cancers, Alzheimer's, and age-related problems. Apples also contain vitamin C, A, E, and beta carotene, which also fight free radicals, boost immune responses, reduce risk of heart disease, asthma, and diabetes. Guys, this all sounds pretty freaking awesome, doesn't it? And that's not all. According to the Institute of Food Research, apples also contain polyphenols, which can block a protein receptor called VEGF, which helps cancer progression in the body. Polyphenols are found naturally in fruits, vegetables, and other things like green tea. But the thing is, apples aren't alone in these properties. Pears contain a lot of the same nutrients. In fact, so do many fruits and berries. Compounds in cranberries and blueberries fight urinary tract infections. Blackberries and strawberries have fiber too. Bananas have potassium, which boosts heart and muscle function. They all have a lot of fructose though, which in large quantities is not great. So don't eat only those things. If you ate only apples, you'd become severely malnourished. No one thing can sustain the human body. We need a variety of different things. What do you think? Do you like apples? What's your favorite fruit? I wanna know. I used to like apples and I think I ate too many. Tell me down in the comments. And if you're like me, you are worried about what will happen to all of our food if nuclear war happens or climate change devastates the planet. But my friend Evan over on Seeker explored the Svalbard seed vault, humanity's last best hope for a tasty future.
For 7 years, this secluded facility has collected seeds from all over the world, keeping them at a constant 0 degrees Fahrenheit. At such freezing temperatures, the seed vault ensures their viability for hundreds, maybe thousands of years.
Thanks for watching DNews, y'all. Subscribe, like, share, love, hugs, eat food. See you later.